Hey, TechKnowSurge. You know, one thing that cryptography allows us to do is secure our information and make sure that we're not vulnerable to attacks. However, cryptography itself can have its own vulnerabilities. So in this video, let's cover what some of those vulnerabilities are and some of the attacks that can be carried out. In this video, we're going to start with cryptographic vulnerabilities. Then we're going to get into cryptographic attacks, and we'll wrap things up talking about the future and how we need to be concerned about the cryptoanalysis that's going to happen in the future and how we can guard against that. One of the things to really watch out for is weak ciphers. There's a lot of ciphers that are out there, so make sure you're choosing a cipher that's considered strong. Another thing that you'll be choosing is which cipher suites you're going to be supporting. So for instance, let's say you have a web server and you are selecting which cipher suites that web server is going to support. You're going to need to know the details of the cipher suites to choose and which ones are acceptable and not acceptable. Not only that, but since things change over time, you'll have to go back and revisit and reevaluate that to make sure that you don't have any ciphers that have changed, cipher suites that have changed and should no longer be supported. Not only choosing the right cipher suites and the right ciphers is going to be important, but how you implement it. There's many different ways that you can implement some of these ciphers, and choosing the right way to implement could make a big difference in how secure it is. One example might be is if you have a choice of the key length is going to be really important to how strong that cipher is. Another thing to watch out for is certificate errors. Watch for things like certificates expiring. Also be concerned about issuing any kind of self-signed certificates that could desensitize your users into accepting things that they shouldn't accept. From an attack standpoint, one of those attacks is the compromised key attack. And just like it sounds, it means that a key has been compromised, or there is someone who has stolen a key or has gained access to a key that shouldn't have access to it. If that's the private key, this can be a lot of problems because somebody can impersonate your website then. Another thing to watch out for is collision attacks or birthday attacks. And this has to do with your hashing algorithms and what hashing algorithms you choose and making sure that they're not susceptible to these type of attacks. One of the things to watch out for is a downgrade attack. That's when there is some sort of machine in the middle that's tricking the communication to communicate not at the proper level. So let me use TLS as an example of this. When you are a web administrator, you're going to choose which TLS versions you're going to support. You're going to draw a line on here. And if you draw the line too low, that means you're supporting more TLS versions than you should, then you're going to have clients connecting and it's going to be in an insecure manner. But if you draw it too high, then you're going to be excluding some of your customers or some of your clients that would normally be connecting to your site. So you have to draw the line at the right spot. But what happens, whatever you are supporting, is a downgrade attack will try to trick this communication into bringing it down to a lower level than it should be. TLS also has the cipher suites that it's going to support. Support too many cipher suites, and it also makes it susceptible to this downgrade attack. And since some of this communication from the beginning is not encrypted, there could be a machine in the middle that gets involved and then downgrades the capabilities of the user. And in doing so, then the communication from then on is going to be at a weaker quality, at not today's standards. Now, in some situations like websites, we may not be concerned with security 10 years from now. That is, we can implement standards that's considered secure now, and we're probably not going to be too concerned with a lot of our sites. However, if it's data that still needs to be secure and relevant 10 years from now, that could be more of a concern because, as we know, the current encryption standards meet our current needs, not our needs 10 years from now. And computers and software and hardware is getting faster and faster at decrypting stuff or this cryptoanalysis where they can reverse engineer this. So we just got to think about that long term. And one of the concerns is with quantum computing. With regular computing, things like our CPUs and our integrated circuits, we have a fairly predictable timeline of when we can crack certain ciphers and when we're getting close to that. However, quantum computing is going to really change things. And that is, it's really set up well to do cracking, to crack ciphers, to figure things out. And so because of that, it could really cause problems with a lot of our current standards. Quantum computing isn't at a level that we need to be all that concerned, at least for a lot of our data. That is, it's not data that's going to be really sensitive 5 or 10 years from now. However, there is this idea of store now and decrypt later. So there could be intercepting communication that's happening now, and let's say it's top secret information that could be still sensitive 5 or 10 years from now. They could have that information, have captured it, and then decrypt it later. That can be problematic, which is one of the reasons that if you do have really super sensitive information and will be for the next 5 or 10 years, you need to be thinking at a level that's greater than our typical encryption level that we have right now. So as you can see, there are some considerations when it comes to implementing cryptography, some vulnerabilities that you need to consider, some attacks, and how are we going to secure things in the future if it's important 5 or 10 years from now.